I know I heard your ear drum here.
My name is Jason, and I use mathematical modeling to drive biological discovery. Now, a lot of people are surprised to hear that math can inform biology. And you've already heard about that in a previous talk, and you will hear about it some more. So let me take a minute and get us all on the same page, let you know what I mean by mathematical modeling. Alright, so on the left is the Merced's original biology, and on the right is state of the art. What inventions allow us to get from there to there? Certainly there's something like the jet engine, the Prion didn't have that. But tell me what was one of the biggest things. Was that mathematicians figured out how to simulate airflow over a wing on a computer. This allowed engineers to rapidly iterate prototypes, a great time and cost saving. And this is what I mean by a mathematical model. It's a set of equations that, when solved, often on a computer, give you insight into a real problem. So, there's a lot of science fiction out here, good and bad, that talks about putting a mind inside of a computer. But what if you put a body inside of a computer? What if instead of building a better wing, you built a better cancer treatment or a better vaccine? And this is what I'm doing with mathematical models. I'm studying a class of neurodegenerative diseases known as prion disease. In particular, I study a class which are known as prions. And so in mammals, prions cause Alzheimer's disease, Kurtzio-Jakob, Kuru, and what you need to know about them is that they're always fatal and incurable. But they're very tough to study because it can take years and decades to manifest symptoms. But it turns out yeast, brewer yeast actually, the same yeast used to make beer, can get prion infections. But they're kind of harmless in yeast, and what's most interesting is that yeast have a mechanism to cure themselves, just like we can cure ourselves of the flu. Yeast can cure themselves of prion diseases. So it seems like a really good target to learn more about these things. And what I did mention is Alzheimer's and Parkinson's are really related to prion diseases. And so biologists have done a lot of work in figuring out the pieces of the puzzle, what genes and repair mechanisms are responsible for this curing. But what they can't tell us is how they fit together. And this is where I come in. I marry mathematical models to experimental data. And I augment that information with knowledge, how these things causally interact with each other, and how prions are capable of actually curing themselves. With this knowledge, which we've made some progress on actually, maybe we can devise new treatments for Alzheimer's or Parkinson's or the various mammalian forms of the prion diseases. So, in a nutshell, that's what I do.